Good morning, boys and girls. It's Miss Sands for our morning meeting today. Just wanted to check in with you and see how you're doing, and just to let you know what our plan is for the day. So today we're going to continue our road trip, and today we are going to the Great Plains, past the Mississippi River, and we're going to end up in Mount Rushmore. And I want to teach you a little trick about Mississippi. So when I was a little girl, my grandma kept me while my mom worked. And so one day, one of my challenge words for spelling was Mississippi. And my grandma taught me this trick on how to spell Mississippi. So I'm going to teach that trick to you today. So the trick is Mississippi is spelled M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. So it's a lot of letters, but here's the trick. You can spell it M-I, crooked letter, I, crooked letter, crooked letter, I, humpback, humpback, I. And you can spell Mississippi. That's a cool little trick. So if anybody says, do you know how to spell Mississippi? You can say, yeah. M-I, crooked letter, I, crooked letter, I, humpback, I, Mississippi. So we're going to go past the Mississippi River today. And then we're going to end up, like I said, in Mount Rushmore, which is a rock that has presidents' faces carved in it. And you know how they carved those faces? They used dynamite. They blew it up. That's how they made some of the parts of the president's faces. So you're going to go there and you're going to read about it in Epic and in our My World book. And then for writing today, you are going to write a journal entry. You're going to pretend like we are on this trip and you are going to tell me about your travels today. Tell me 5 things that you either learned or saw on our trip. And then once you finish that, you are going to draw me a picture of Mount Rushmore at the bottom. And it's gray. It looks like rock, so you should probably use either a gray crayon or your pencil to color in Mount Rushmore. In Bible today, we're going to continue talking about Peter. We've talked about how Peter was just like us and that he made mistakes, but that Jesus is so gracious and he restored Peter. And today we're going to talk about how Peter was bold and Peter had courage. And we're going to talk about how Peter interacted with a beggar. And so at the bottom of my plans, just like yesterday, there's going to be a voice link for you to listen to today's plan. And story about Peter and how he was bold and courageous and actually maybe gave somebody a really good gift. And I want you to see if you can figure out what that gift is. Let's see what else. Math today, we're going to talk about add-ins of 3. So we're going to talk about adding 3 numbers together. I have linked a video for you to watch on how to do this. And at the bottom, I have taken a picture of a page that I did with some examples. So you can see how I added groups of 3. What you're going to do really is you're going to take 2 of the numbers and add them together and then add the answer of these 2 to this number. But I've showed you on a piece of paper at the bottom. IXL was not working this morning when I went to check all my links, so we are not going to do IXL today. I'm going to work on that this afternoon, and I'll let you know if it's up and running by tomorrow. So if you have trouble with it, this morning when I logged on, it said that the trial had expired, which shouldn't be the case. So I'm going to work on that today. In spelling, we're going to do pages 147 and 148. We are going to continue working on TH and WH. We will have a spelling test on Friday. Remember, there are no challenge words. And let's see. In language, we're going to do workbook page 90. Just complete that and send a picture. And in writing, today's writing is another would you rather. Would you rather have a pet fish or a pet bird? And you're going to tell me 3 reasons why you pick that pet. And then tell me at the end, blank would be a better pet. I think I would pick a fish than a bird. I don't know. Bird might talk to me and stuff, and it might say things that I say, and I don't know if I want to hear a bird talking all night. So I'd probably pick a fish because they're pretty quiet. But that's my opinion. In your can-dos today, on your can-dos, you can visit a farm. So I have found a link for a farm that you can go on a virtual tour, and you can see them harvesting wheat and getting eggs and feeding the pigs, all kinds of things on the farm. And I want you to think, what would your favorite job be on a farm? And then for play, you can today find time to maybe do a puzzle or play a game with somebody. In Epic, I've created and assigned a collection of books about the Great Plains. I have assigned those, but you do not have to read all of those books. The one collection book is assigned today, but the rest of them are just if you want to do some more reading on Mount Rushmore or the Great Plains. And then write. You guys love writing stories where I give you words. So today for your can-do writing is write a story using these 5 words. Cow, chicken, barn, farmer, horse. It can be a silly story. It can be a crazy story. It can even be a sad story. But write me a story if you want using those 5 words. Couple things to tell you about today. So one is today is Wednesday, so it's Wacky Sock Wednesday. So I am wearing my wacky sock. So hope you guys can find some wacky socks to put on and maybe send me a picture of you wearing those. And we also have something super special about today. Today is Lily's birthday. So happy birthday, Lily. I'm so sad that we can't be together to celebrate, but know that I am celebrating you from my house and we are all celebrating you from afar and we love you and we are so thankful that God created you and that you are a part of our class. We love you so much. So happy birthday, Lily. Boys and girls, it's going to be a great day. I am so thankful to be your teacher and to connect with you this way. So I hope you have a great day and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Great job on all your work. Peace out.